To get started with Mendelian Exome or Gene Panel Analysis in Lasergene, first, create a new assembly in SeqMan Engine. Next, select the Exome and Gene Panel workflow. In this example, we'll be looking at Illumina whole exome sequencing data for a trio of human samples from the Ceph pedigree. So next, we'll select reference-based assembly, and then load in our genome template. In this example, I'm going to be adding the human genome template package that I previously downloaded from the DNASTAR website. On this screen, you can also load a VCF file if you have a custom SNP database you want to search against. And because we're working with targeted resequencing data, we also need to load a bed file that defines the target capture regions. Next, select your read technology and load your read data. So here I'm going to load a folder of reads for each sample. Then specify that we're running multiple sample data and enter a name for each sample. Next, you have the option to set a control experiment. Then, on the Assembly Options page, I'll select Diploid Variant Detection. And because we're working with human data, I'm also going to import data from the Variant Annotation Database. And note that by default, SeqMan Engine will also calculate copy number variation. We'll cover this in another video. Next, I need to specify the gender for each of my samples. And now we just need to name the project and specify a project folder to save the completed assembly. Then click Start Assembly to begin aligning your reads. Once the assembly is complete, launch the results in ArrayStar to begin variant analysis. Within ArrayStar, each assembly is listed as a separate experiment. If we open up the SNP table, we can now see all variants detected during assembly. If desired, we can do some quick filtering on this list to show, for example, only user SNPs. These are the variants that are present in the VCF file we loaded during assembly. Or we could show only non-synonymous SNPs. Note that you can also customize the columns displayed in this table to show a variety of SNP statistics and annotations from the Variant Annotation Database, including information on allele and genotype frequencies, functional predictions, conservation information, and pathogenicity. To really filter down to SNPs of interest, I'm going to use the Filter All option, and then I'm going to specify my SNP criteria. So for this example, I want to look for non-synonymous SNPs that occur in the daughter, and also occur in areas with assembly coverage of 20x or more. So I'll do this search and then save this as a SNP set. I can then repeat this search for my other samples. I can then compare those SNP sets in the Venn diagrams view. So here I can easily see what SNPs in the daughter are shared with the mother or father or both parents. I can then select a subset here and view those variants in the SNP table. At this point, you can further narrow down your SNP set using the Filter Selected menu option and search on additional statistical or annotation criteria. Or you can just browse this table for interesting information. So for example, if I sort on this ClinVar clinical significance column, I see variants that are likely pathogenic sorted together. Once I find a gene or variant of interest, I can make a selection, right-click, and send it to SeqMan Pro to view the read alignment at that position. I can also send my selection to GenVision Pro. And within GenVision Pro, I can view the assembly coverage for all of my samples simultaneously. To learn more about our software, request a free trial, or see more videos like this one, please visit our website.